Are you guys enjoying the service so far like me?
Yes.
It has been an amazing one, and the presence of God is here, and you know that the Lord is doing a new thing and a great thing. So in the interest of time, I want us to listen to the word today, and we are so privileged to have a friend, a brother, a colleague, and a man we love. He's been part of this journey since we started the well. And for those who are new, the well, we are just celebrating 1 year since we began meeting in person. And there were about 6 months we were meeting online. But the church has been going on because the church belongs to Jesus. Amen. So our brother Boniface Nganga will share the word of God with us. He's a married man with two boys and a girl, if I don't forget. And where is your wife? I haven't seen her sometime. I think she's around, okay? But why don't you put our hands together as you welcome Bonnie and share the word of God with us.
Good morning, everybody. Or is it already afternoon?
Not yet.
It's not yet. It's a few minutes to afternoon. Can I just ask us to stand for a minute? Just stand for 1 minute. Would you just stretch your hands towards God and just give him thanks? This is a Thanksgiving Sunday. Just thank him. Just thank him for his goodness. Thank him for his grace. Thank him for his love. Thank him for his preservation in 2020. We are only here because God has kept us. God has preserved us. God has been with us. He has journeyed with us. And we can surely say, had it not been for the Lord that was on our side, let Israel now say, had it not been for the Lord that stood with us, that journeyed with us, that empowered us, that preserved us, where would we be, oh God, if it were not for your mighty hand, if it were not for your great grace, almighty God, if it were not for your incredible mercy preserving us and keeping us, oh God. Father, we are grateful. Father, we are grateful. We rejoice in your goodness. We rejoice in your grace. Lord, look at how you have kept our families. You've kept our children. You've kept us, oh God. Lord, there is no day we have suffered any lack or hunger, Lord. Father, you have been on our side every day. You have been by us, before us, behind us, on our side, almighty God. We give you praise and we give you glory today. We have appeared on your mountain to say thank you, Lord. We have appeared in your house to glorify your name, Lord. We are not ashamed to say, oh God, that if you are the only reason that we've come, the Father, we've come, oh God. You are the only reason for our being alive today. You are the only reason for our being healthy today. You are the only reason for what we eat, for what we drink, the air we breathe, almighty God. It is taken your hand. It has taken your grace. It has taken your mercy, oh God. And we bless you today. We give you all the praise and we give you all the glory. Father, we honor your name today. We have come to declare that you are our God. We have come to declare that you are our rock. We have come to declare that you are our shield, the mighty God, the glory and the lifter of our head. We thank you that you've not allowed the enemies to swallow us alive, but you've been with us, lifting us, oh God, and shifting our levels from glory to glory. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we glorify your name today. Our families are together because of your hand. Our children are growing because of your hand. Our businesses are starting because of your hand. Our careers are stable because of your hand. Lord, we bless you today, and we give you all the glory. We give you all the honor today, Lord. We did not come to hear somebody preach. We came to say thank you, oh God. We came to lift up our voices. We came to say glory and honor belongs to you. You are the great I am. You are the King of glory. You are the
presence once again. Fill us with your glory once again. Fill us with your power once again. Come on, somebody, just open up your mouth for a minute and say, Lord, fill me. Fill me with the spirit of praise. Fill me with the spirit of thanksgiving. Fill me with the spirit that allows me to give an acceptable sacrifice of praise before you, Lord. That I may not be a grumbler. That I may not be a complainer. That I may be one that gives glory to God every single day of my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, we bless you today. And we honor you, King of all glory. Be magnified, be magnified, be magnified, be magnified, oh God. Father, we come to say you've been Adonai in our lives. We come to say you've been Ebenezer in our lives. We come to say, Lord, had it not been for you who was on our side, we would not be where we were, oh God. You have not left us to the masses of our enemies, oh God. But you've walked with us, you've walked with us. You've walked with the well church, oh God. You've walked with every family in this place, oh God. We give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. Hallelujah. So, Heavenly Father, for the few minutes that we get to open the word, Lord, I pray that you're going to speak to us. Lord, I pray that you hide me behind the cross, oh God, that only the voice of your heart will be heard, oh God, that only the desire that you have desired to speak to your people will come forth, oh God. I pray that my mind, my mouth, my lips, oh God, I surrender them to you, and I pray today, oh God, that the few minutes that I'm sharing, oh God, may your spirit take over, oh God. I am not intelligent enough, oh God, to speak to these your dear children, and so I pray today, oh God, may your breath take over, may your mind take over, may your spirit take over, oh God. And in the name of Jesus, I pray that you're going to remind us of the oracles of your word. I pray that, God, you're going to speak expressly to us, oh God. I pray that, God, your word will bring revival to our souls and to our lives, oh God. Father, we give you all the glory and we give you all the praise today. Once again, as we sit at your feet for the next few minutes, we invite the presence of the Holy Spirit. He's the best teacher, the most articulate teacher, the teacher that understands how to communicate to us at our level. Lord, I pray that today may you fill my voice with the power of the Holy Spirit, that Lord, as I speak your word to your children, Lord, it is going to come through with authority and with power and with simplicity, Almighty God. And Lord, I pray that I shall not receive any credit for anything you will do, oh God, but you alone will receive the glory and you alone will receive the praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Psalms chapter 9, before we sit down, Psalms chapter 9 and Psalms chapter 30. I'm going to be very brief in the few minutes that I have to share God's word. If you are in Psalms chapter 9 from verse 1 to 4, this is what God's word says. I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart. I want you to take note of those words. He says, I will. So gratitude is a matter of choice, not a matter of your circumstances. There is no circumstance that you can ever go through that can kill your ability to give thanks if you decide to give thanks. Thanksgiving is a decision, not an emotion. And so he continues to say, I will tell of your wonders. So gratitude has an expression. There is no such thing as silent gratitude. Gratitude has an expression. He says, I will tell of your wonders. That's why we give testimonies. That's why we talk about the things that God has done, because we have to tell of the wonders of God. Any silent thanksgiving is counterfeit thanksgiving. Any genuine thanksgiving that comes from your heart, Jesus says, out of the abundance of the heart, your mouth will speak. And so you cannot have a silent mouth when you have a grateful heart. I will tell of your wonders. Verse 2, he says, I will be glad. In other words, when you give thanks to God out of your will and you become expressive with your thanksgiving, the spirit of depression is muzzled. You cannot be grateful and be depressed at the same time. He says, when you tell of the wonders of God, there is a spirit of gladness, there is a spirit of joy that takes over your life. And then he says, I will sing praise to your name, O Most High God. There is a vocal expression that comes with giving thanks to God. Verse 3, he says, when my enemies stand back, they stumble and perish before you. For you have maintained my just cause. You have sat on the throne judging righteously. Psalms chapter 30, very quickly, so that we share in another like 10 or 15 minutes. Psalms chapter 30. This is again David giving praise to God after he began the process of dedicating the house of God. Psalms chapter 30 and verse 1. He says, I will extol you, O Lord, for you have lifted me up. Is there anybody in here that can say God has lifted me up? Is there anybody in this house that can say God has lifted me up? Verse number 2. He says, and he has not let my enemies rejoice over me. He has not let my enemies rejoice over me. Sickness is your enemy. Do you know the reason you don't have corona is not because you put on a mask, and thank God for masks. It is not because you sanitize every day, thank God for sanitizing. It is because God has not allowed your enemies to triumph over you. And that's why you need to give God thanks. He has not allowed your enemies to triumph over you. Verse number 2, he says, oh Lord my God. It's a personal thing. There is nothing like corporate thanksgiving when you have private grumbling. It is your private thanksgiving that culminates in corporate praise. In other words, it has got to be a personal thing. Verse number 2 says, I cry to you for help. I've had so many testimonies here that I was just rejoicing. I was saying my preaching is already done. Because we have had testimony from Batia. We have heard from somebody that said, I cry to the Lord and he healed me.
Hallelujah.
Not only did he heal you, verse number 3, the Bible says, oh Lord, you have brought my soul from Sheol. You have kept me alive that I would not go down to the pits. Sing praise to God, you his godly ones, and give thanks to his holy name. Verse number 7, oh Lord, by your favor, you have made my mountain to stand strong.
Yes.
By your favor, you've made my mountain to stand strong. In the next few minutes, I want to share a very short word, just about 10 minutes. You can have your blessed seats in the presence of God. I want to share a very short word. And as I was just praying when George just invited me to come and share, I had God give me a challenge that I want to give to you. And the challenge is, you must move from thanksgiving to thanksgiving. In other words, thanksgiving must stop being an event and become a culture that defines how you live your life. It must become a daily occurrence and a constant attitude of your heart. Because when you don't develop a culture of thanksgiving, you cannot maintain the presence of God around you. The culture of thanksgiving. And so in Psalms chapter 9, David says, I will give thanks to God with all my heart. I will tell of your wonderful deeds. And so David is actually saying, and I was reading something interesting the other day, and somebody said that David used to pray about 10 times a day, but of the 10 times he would pray, 7 of the times was not about requesting things from God. He was just coming to the house of God and saying, God, I am grateful. You have blessed me, Lord. I am grateful. You have healed me, God. I am grateful. You provided for me. Anytime you don't give thanks to God, you trivialize his goodness in your life. Grumbling is an attitude that grows when we are blind to the goodness of God. So there are 3 kinds of people that are seated in this room today. 3 kinds of people. Number 1, and I want you to audit yourself and see where you are. And I'm going to teach in a very short while. Number 1, they are what I call the miserable grumblers. For them, they are just waiting for 2020 to end, and they are thinking that a day, 1st of January 2021, will change anything. Let me tell you, dates don't change anything. It is your attitude that changes your circumstances. Don't wait for the 1st of January 2021 for you to change
your attitude and stop grumbling about how difficult the year has been and decide, I will bless the Lord, I will extol the Lord, I will not grumble, I will not murmur, I will not complain, I will not have negativity, I will praise the Lord. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times.
Amen. Hallelujah.
There is no good time to grumble, and there is no bad time to give thanks to God. So, now, category number one of people are what I call the miserable grumblers. And let me tell you something that happens to the children of Israel when they are going through the wilderness and they begin to face these very difficult circumstances. They begin grumbling. And guess what? A lot of the people that grumbled, they aborted the promise of God because their grumbling disconnected them from the promiser. Anytime you grumble, anytime you complain, anytime you murmur, you disconnect yourself from the promises of God, from the possibilities of God. Don't look back at the year with a complaining attitude. That shows that you're blind to the goodness of God. I was talking to a friend of mine and I was telling them, one of my friends was called Bishop Amke. This guy, I saw him like a week ago, and a week later I received a call saying this guy had died of COVID. And I was wondering, how come this guy has died? He's serving God. God, what have I done to be alive? I don't have any reason to complain. By the way, anytime you complain, you perpetuate the agenda of the enemy in your life and you stop the agenda of God from taking root in your life. The miserable grumbler. Numbers chapter 14 and verse number 23. The Israelites grumbled against Moses and Aaron and against the whole assembly and said, if only we had died in Egypt. They forgot about where God was taking them to, because they were trapped by the negativity of where they are. You see, the spirit of praise is sustained when you look back at where God has brought you from and you look forward to where God is taking you to. The spirit of praise is graduated and sustained by a spirit of a good memory and a strong vision. Miserable grumblers, looking at life and murmuring about the disappointments of the year to the extent that you smother the possibilities of tomorrow. Had an interesting story about a guy who was living with his wife, and he had been married for about 20 years. And those of us who are here and you've been married for over 10 years, you know sometimes when you're married for long, you begin behaving like a brother and a sister instead of behaving like a wife and a husband. You begin to trivialize the goodness of your spouse. And so this guy observed the marriage and he realized the marriage was going down. And he went to a seminar. And in the seminar they told him, if you want to revive your marriage life, if you want to stop being a brother to your wife and start being a lover to your wife, go buy an empty diary. And every day in that diary, not something that you're grateful for. Not something that you're grateful for. She cooks a good meal, note it down. She does the clothing for you, note it down. She collects that sauce that you left under the table, dear husband, note it down. And he began writing down, and he began writing down. And the next year when they were having their anniversary, he didn't have money to give to his wife. He went and he took that diary where he had written 365 reasons why I am grateful for my wife. And he wrapped it in a good gift wrapper and he gave it to the wife. And the wife opened it. She was excited. She was wondering, what is this thing that is wrapped with such magnificence? And she opened it up and she started seeing the diary. On day number one, my husband says he is grateful for this. Day number two, by the time she got to day number 10, she was crying. Because any time you show gratitude to a giver, you attract more generosity from that giver. She understood that you cannot build anything by crumbling, but when you give thanks, you release the spirit of vision and the spirit of grace over your life. Don't be a miserable crumbler. Look at your neighbor and tell them, don't be a miserable crumbler. If you think your children are bad, talk to somebody who is believing God for children. Then you will realize you are blessed. You know, one time where I'm a pastor, you know, my son had done some Drama is cool. And so I was summoned to the school. I was told, come to the school because your son is causing problems. And so I went there. And you know, when you're a pastor, you have an image to protect. By the way, one of the signs that God has not killed your ego is that you're more image conscious than integrity conscious. So I went there and I was feeling very ashamed because I knew most of the members of our congregation are parents in that school. And I went there and the teacher sat me down and began telling me about all the things that this my boy is doing. And as I was going home, I am red in color. Smoke is coming out of my ears. I can't wait to get home to, you know, to sort of kill this boy. Because of shaming me. I'm a pastor. I'm a man of God. The children of men of God are supposed to be good children, right? Until I began to go home and God began to challenge my heart and I began to ask myself, how many people are praying to have a child that will give them that little trouble and they've waited for 20 years and here I am complaining about a child that has misbehaved only for 1 week. Grumbling is blindness to the goodness of God. If you are a grumbler, you can never scale the mountain of greatness with the attitude of grumbling. David said, I will extol the Lord. I will bless the Lord. Numbers chapter 14, the Bible says they grumbled. I cannot begin to tell you how many people are going down, not because they are going, they cannot go up, but their mouth will not let them go up. Your mouth will never let you go up if it's filled with grumbling. Never go up. The promised land is for thanksgivers, not for complainers. The miserable grumblers. You must liberate yourself. You must tell your mouth, even when you feel tempted to complain. When you're taking strungi in your house and you're feeling tempted to complain, realize that whatever it is that you want to complain about, it is a miracle somebody else is believing God for. The other day, we were just having a chat with my wife, and we've lived in the same, you know, I was born in a neighborhood called, Umoja Inako, and I've grown in that neighborhood, and so we just started having this conversation, and you know, we were just saying, how long are we going to live here? And I remember that next morning, I went to my prayer closet, and the Lord reminded me, you are complaining about being in Inako. There is somebody who is in Kayole that is praying, God, if you can take me to that Inako, I will give you thanks for the rest of my life. If you complain that you don't have shoes, there is somebody who doesn't have a leg to put a shoe in. Be grateful. Don't be a miserable grumbler. By the way, grumblers are always miserable. And grumbling always abhors the favor of God. Miserable grumblers. Category number two is what I call the proud chest thumpers. You know, there are people who believe that they don't need God. They believe that they have everything figured out. When you get in trouble, they know which policeman to call and they know which OCPD to call. My mother the other day went for a rurashio, a ceremony somewhere in Ushago, and one of the guys came there and he lived somewhere in Nyandarua County. And this guy was saying, you know what, I never worry about being caught by the police because I know the OCPD. It doesn't matter which cop will arrest me. I just call the OCPD and then I am let loose. And I realized that's a proud chest thumper. In the Bible, in Daniel chapter 4 and verse 30, we see the story of a man there. And this guy was called Nebuchadnezzar. And he had built a magnificent kingdom. One day he woke up and he said, is this not the great Babylon that I have built as the royal residence by my might and my power for the glory of my majesty? Proud chest thumper. Let me tell you, don't overestimate what your CV can do for you. You can have your CV with all the masters and more degrees like a thermometer and never go anywhere except God fights for you. Don't be a proud chest thumper. Let me talk to those parents who, when you see another parent's children misbehaving, you begin to stamping. I have raised children and I know how to raise children and I know how to discipline children. Let me tell you something. Thank God for his favor. Don't just thump. You have not lived long enough to face life and face an adversity that your own mechanisms and your own attributes cannot sort out. Don't be
fear Nebuchadnezzar. And guess what? When Nebuchadnezzar began to chest thump, you know what God said? God said, I am going to make you eat grass for several years so that you can realize who is in charge here. Tell your neighbor, you are good, but you're not that good. Just tell them. Just tell them. Yeah, just look at your neighbor. You are good, but you're not that good. You are good, but you're not that good. Don't be consumed with your ego and think about how good you are. You are not making a profit because you are a smart businessman. You are making a profit because God has shown you favor. If God removes his favor, you will be surprised at how... Let me not use that word. Tell your neighbor, don't be a proud chest thumper. There are people who are thinking that the reason why they made the way to December is because they put on a mask and they were able to sanitize and they were able to do everything right. That's not the position. Don't be a Nebuchadnezzar. Your power is too limited to handle your life. You need an extra power from God. Don't be a proud chest thumper. Proud chest thumper. Tell your neighbor, don't be a proud chest thumper. Tell them, don't be a miserable crumbler. And let me tell you something. When the enemy wants to bring you down, sometimes he doesn't make you sin. You know, Christians have learned how to say no to lust, but they cannot say no to gossip. Christians know how to say no to bribing, but they cannot say no to complaining. Let me ask you a question. If everything you complained about was taken away by God, how much would you remain with? Proud chest thumper. The category number three that I want to bring you to. God said, don't be a miserable grumbler. Don't be a proud chest thumper. Be a lavishful praiser. Be a lavishful praiser. Psalms chapter 34 and verse number 2. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will continually be in my mouth. David said, you know what? For so long as I go through my life, I may not know how to do anything else, but I am an expert in thanksgiving. And let me tell you something. God does not need you to be an expert in many things. But if you can be an expert in thanksgiving, whatever you thank him for will keep multiplying in your life. You know, you can be a wife and you're here. And every time you're complaining about your husband, why can't you put your socks where you're supposed to put them? Why do you drink with the cup and you put it under the chair? Why do you do this and you do that? And you forget that there is a woman that is praying for half the kind of a man that you are. And you're there busy complaining about a blessing that God has given you. Malachi chapter 4, God says that he turned the blessings of the priests into curses because they did not know how to give thanks. Let me read that for you. Malachi, the last book in the Old Testament, very quickly. And then I'm going to give you four simple things that I believe are going to be helpful for you. Malachi, go to Malachi. Very, 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 very fast. Malachi. Malachi chapter 2 and from verse number 1. And now this commandment is for you, O priests. If you do not listen, if you do not take it to heart to give honor to my name, says the Lord of hosts. Malachi chapter 2 and verse 1. Verse number 2 says, then I will send the curse upon you and I will curse your blessings. Look at what God is saying. He's saying, if you don't take it to heart to give praise to me, guess what I'm going to do? Even those things that you're calling blessings in your life. Ask your neighbor, are you blessed? Ask your neighbor very fast. Are you blessed? Now tell them, if you don't give honor to God, if you don't give honor to God, this is, I promise you, you don't need prophet or word to come here and promise you. I promise you, if you don't give praise to God, and if you don't give thanks to God, the Bible says, then I will send the curse upon you, and I will curse your blessings. Have you ever heard something like cursing blessings? You know that doesn't even sound like good English, eh? God says, yes, you're blessed, but because you're not giving honor to my name, guess what I'm going to do? I am going to curse your blessings. Let me tell you, the more being cursed is a bad thing, eh? But having a blessing and then it is cursed, that is even more worse. Because you have tasted the blessing, but now God says this blessing, because you're not giving honor to my name, I am going to curse your blessing. Indeed, I have cursed them already. Look at what God is. I have cursed them already. I have cursed them already because you're not taking it to heart. You know, most people know Malachi 3:10, eh? You need to know Malachi chapter 2 and verse 1. If you don't give it to your heart to give thanks to God and to give praise to God, you become a murmurer and a chest thumper. God says, I am going to curse your blessings. You are going to have a car, and that car will not be a blessing for you. It's a point enda kwa barabara, inaangusha exhaust pipe. You go to collect that exhaust pipe. You burn your hands because you are not giving God thanks. That blessing will become a curse. But the third level of living is where you become a lavish thanksgiver. At all times, every day, when you're walking on the road, you say, Lord, I thank you I have feet to walk. I thank you that I am not crippled. I thank you that, Lord, I have shoes. I may not have bus fare, but I thank you that I have feet to be. I don't need Mitsubishi. For those of you who believe having a car is the blessing, it's good to have a car, but it is better to have legs and you can walk wherever your car cannot take you. The legs that God gave you can take you there. Don't grumble about it. Don't complain about it. Lest your blessings be turned to curses. Be a lavish thanksgiver, a lavish praiser. Have you ever realized that the people you are most motivated to be generous to are the most grateful to you for your generosity? The people who show you gratitude when you do something small, they make a big deal out of it. They magnify it. Those are the same people you want to be a blessing to. How much more God? Tell your neighbor, don't be a miserable crumbler. Don't be a proud chest thumper. Be a lavish praiser. But it's a formula for you to be a lavish praiser. Let me give you four things about people who are lavish praisers or lavish thanksgivers. Number one, the four R's of a thanksgiver. Number one, they are reflective. They are reflective. Tell your neighbor, be reflective. You know what being reflective is? Being reflective means you always audit the good things that are happening in your life. One time I went to counsel a certain couple somewhere. And interestingly, when I walked into their house, there was this very beautiful calendar. You know those calendars that are one pager? And in that calendar, there were dates that were circled with a red marker pen. Circled with a red marker pen. And this couple was fighting. In fact, all of them wanted out of the relationship. None of them wanted to stay in that relationship. And as I'm talking to them, and I tried to talk to them, I didn't seem like I was getting anywhere. But when I left, and the gentleman that was the husband of this woman was giving me a push, I decided to ask him something interesting. I asked him, by the way, I noticed in your house that calendar has all very different dates marked with a red marker pen. What is all that marking on the calendar? You know what he said? Every time he wrongs the wife, it goes on record. It goes on record. Lest we forget, it goes on record. On 5th of January 2014, you did not bring nyama choma like you promised. Even the one that you brought the next day had been overcooked and it was overburned. And I noted it just for memory. Your memory must not be an archive of the negativities of your life. Your memory must be an archive of the goodness of God, an archive of the deeds of God, an archive of the testimonies of God. Amen. Be reflective. If you study the journey of the children of Israel, as they were moving, God would tell them, put a memorial here. And they would build an altar and they would mark that place so that they can remember something God did. Grumbling is fueled by memorizing the wrong events of your life. Grumbling. It is fueled by memorizing the wrong events of your life. The only thing you remember is when you were sacked and when the boss didn't do. When was the last time you sat down and decided, I am going to archive the goodness of God? I am going, the way there is a national archive to memorize in our country, why don't you have an archive where you archive the things that God has done for you? Be reflective. The more you remember the good God has done, the more you disempower the enemy from discouraging you about what God is yet about to do. Be reflective. Tell your neighbor, be reflective. Tell your neighbor again, be reflective. Do you know how much would change in our lives if we just decided to remember good things more? Those children that have become teenagers and they're giving you a headache. Let me not call it hell on earth. There is nothing like hell on earth. Earth will never know what hell looks like. Eh? So don't desire to go to hell. Desire not to go there so that you don't find out how it looks like. If they are giving you a headache, why not audit the little blessings they have been in your life? Wow. Be reflective. Be reflective. Tell your neighbor, be reflective. Number two, very quickly, be responsive. Be responsive. Gratitude is being responsive about the goodness of God. Open up your mouth. Once you reflect and you remember something God has done, open up your mouth and say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I glorify you. Lord, I am thankful that you've done me well. Gratitude has a language. Gratitude is not silent. Be responsive. You have to allow your mouth to be a carrier of thanksgiving, not a carrier of complaining. Be responsive. Be responsive. You must release a sound from your heart that tells God, I am aware of your goodness. I am aware of your mercy. I am aware of your great love in my life. I am aware that where I am only there by the grace of God. Be responsive. Be reflective. Be responsive. And lastly, be regular. Tell your neighbor, be regular. You know what it means to be regular? To be regular means that you don't wait for December to say thank you to God. Thanksgiving is not an occasional event that needs to be scheduled towards the end of the year. It needs to be a daily, it needs to be regular. Don't wait for the end of the year to be grateful. Be grateful every day. Inculcate the culture, the discipline of gratitude every day. Let me tell you something. A friend of mine told me something very interesting. Let me tell all the men a secret of living with any woman, no matter how much of a complainer she is. Eh? You know the Bible says it's better to dwell on a rooftop than with her. So this guy told me, anytime your wife presses your buttons, eh? Are you listening to me, gentlemen?
Yes.
Anytime your wife presses your buttons, hold your mouth and bring to your memory something good that your wife has done. And guess what is going to happen to all the negative energy that is building up in your system? It is going to dissolve miraculously.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I tell your neighbor, now you know better. Be regular. I was reading a research that was saying, and then this will help the men as I bring this conversation to a close. I was reading an interesting research that was saying that there, you know, Gary Chapman wrote a book called The Five Languages of Love. Now let me tell you, the one supernatural language of love that every woman understands, gratitude and affirmation. And it is the same thing God looks for. God says, I am looking for a worshiper, somebody who can express gratitude and affirmation of the things that I have done. Now, if you get it right with God, God will help you to make it easier for your wife. By the way, any man that does not effectively worship God will be a castigator of his wife. Be regular. God wants you to thank him all the time. You're thanking him. Your prayers should be 70% thanksgiving, 30% petitions. Not 70% petitions. God give me. God bless me. God do this. What about what he has done? What are you doing about it? Are you thanking him? Are you glorifying him? Are you telling him, Lord, conscious. I am conscious, oh God. I am not going to be a complainer. I know. 2020 has been a tough year, but the toughness of the experience should not dictate the regularity of your praise. 2020 has been a lean year, but guess what? It has shifted our minds so that we realize it is God who takes care of us, not our salaries. It is not Job Jireh that takes care of you. It is not business Jireh that takes care of you. It is Jehovah Jireh that takes care of you. And so this season is a refocusing season. To break all the idols that we have exalted, to break all those connections that we have put in the place of God, so that we can realize God can be bad all by himself. He doesn't need your network to provide for you. He doesn't need your connection to come through for you. He just needs your faith and your gratitude. Yeah. 2020 has been challenging. It has been a weighty year. But don't allow the weight of your circumstances to determine the weight of your praise. If you can raise the weight of your praise above the intensity of your adversity, guess what? Your adversity will pass and it will leave you standing. You will be the last man standing. If you can learn the secret of being gratitude. Tell your neighbor, be reflective. Now tell your neighbor with some swag. Tell your neighbor, be reflective. Allow your mind to go back and see the goodness of God. Allow your mind to go back and reflect on where God has brought you from. If you're a single lady and you've been believing God for a husband, don't grumble and say all men are dogs like all other young ladies are saying. If they are dogs, then God is not interested in giving you a dog. That's why you're waiting. Change your language. Change your language. It doesn't matter who left you. God was. Let me tell you something. Most breakups are divine interventions for the protection of the destinies of the children of God. They just don't see. Be reflective. Be reflective. Look back. Look back and see the little things God has done. And don't just be reflective, be responsive. Say, Lord, I am conscious, I am aware, I am voicing it out. Any thanksgiving that is not vocalized is incomplete thanksgiving. Can you imagine you bought your daughter or your son a new iPhone? What are they calling it? iPhone 11 or something? You know? And then you brought it to them and they just took it and they started smiling. And then you say, by the way, you cannot even say thank you. And then they say, I was thanking you in my heart. You will take that thing away from them and you will tell them, the day you will learn how to be thankful, then I can release more blessing and resources your way. Be responsive. Be responsive. Then number three, be regular. Be regular. Now let me tell you something. I have discovered a secret of breaking the spirit of discouragement. Anytime discouragement will attempt to arrest me, I discovered I don't need to pray. I just need to thank.
Hallelujah.
People who live with a life and a culture of thanksgiving don't need to bind the discouragement. You know, to pray those Nigerian prayers, I bind this snake of discouragement and this dragon. You don't need all that drama. Just open up your mouth and cultivate regular thanksgiving. And guess what? The regularity of your thanksgiving will determine the longevity of your joy.
Amen.
Joy cannot abide where thanksgiving is not regular. Make it regular. Make it regular, irregardless of what you face. Make it regular. Doesn't matter what life throws at me. I'm not going to lose my gratitude. I want you to stand up on your feet for a minute and reflect on 2020. Don't reflect on the things you've lost. Don't reflect on the things that didn't go right. Just those few snippets of the goodness of God. Reflect upon them. Reflect upon them. And allow your mind to go back and pick the archives of the memories of the goodness of God. And begin to just allow that to roll in your mind. To roll in your mind. To roll in your mind. Open up. Open up your mind. The archives of your mind. Allow your mind to go back. The goodness of God. And now, as you reflect, allow yourself to begin to respond to God and say, God, I am conscious of your goodness in this area. I am conscious of your goodness in this area, this other area. Lord, you bless me. Lord, you lifted my hand. I am conscious. It doesn't matter what I don't have. I am aware that you've given me beyond what I would ever have imagined, oh God. I am aware. I am aware of your goodness. I am aware. I am responding to your goodness. I am responding to your goodness. I am responding to your goodness. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, I refuse to be a miserable grumbler. I refuse to be a complainer. I refuse to look at what you've not done, oh God. You have done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. You have done so much for me. My mind cannot even wrap around what you've done, oh God. I am grateful. I am grateful. I am grateful. I am grateful, oh God. Rebagado Saragana. Come on, I want you to respond to God. I want you to respond to the goodness of God. I want you to respond to the mercy of God. I want you to respond to the favor of God. I want you to respond to the doings of God in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, the favor of God has preserved you. The hand of God has preserved you. In the mighty name of Jesus, can you be responsive to God? Can you be responsive to God? Just stop and think that it is your muscle and your mind or your connections. It is the hand of God. It is the hand of God. It is the hand of God that has brought you the far that you come. By the favor of God, He has made your mountain to stand stronger. By the favor of God, He has made your mountain to stand strong today. Bless your name, Jesus. We give you all. all the glory and honor and majesty, O God. La kataya barudu sandia, libagana ya salere atanda rababus, rebala sharia darabandia. We come to give you our sacrifice of praise, our sacrifice of thanksgiving, our sacrifice of praise. We bless your name, 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 Jesus. Rakataya badusha rakandia barataza. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Father, we come to lay everything at your feet as we recognize that you've been Adonai in our lives, O God. You've been our glory. You've been the lifter of our heads, O God. You've been the God, our keeper. You've been the God, our provider. You've been the God, our protector. You've been the God that has walked with us in tough places, in difficult places, in wildernesses that we never knew we were going to make it through. Lord, by your mighty hand, you brought us out, O God. So, Lord, we come to give you thanks. Can I just request you to stand up in your seat? Just want to request you to stand up as we honor God. Just one more time. Just one more time. Just as we honor God. As we honor God. As we honor God. He has been so good. We just want to be people who give thanks because it's an occasion. We want to make it a culture in our lives. We want to make it a ritual to give thanks to God. We want to make it a tradition every day, every moment, every hour. There will be a praise bubbling up from the inside of us as we recognize the goodness of God. We want to thank Him. We want to thank Him today. Hallelujah. 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 In your own words, just open up your mouth for one more minute, for one more minute. We cannot tire to give thanks to God. We cannot tire to give glory to God. We cannot tire to be regular. We cannot tire to be reflective. We cannot tire to be responsive. We can give Him the glory. We can give Him the praise. We can give Him the honor because He has been faithful in our life. Thank you. antes, porque a Shiva na imagem, porque a Shiva na imagem, Jehová. Muito lindo é o abudinho, é barba, o eximile, o eximile, o eximile, o metena mambo macu, o metena mambo macu, o metena mambo macu, Jehová. Unastahili sifa, unastahili ibada, unastahili heshima, unastahili kuabudiwa na kuinuliwa Bwana. Tunasema ni asante. Just one more time, just one more time. Just one more time, just one more time as we thank him. As we thank him, we just want to recognize that the faithfulness of God is not just to us. The Bible says his faithfulness is from generation to generation to generation. His faithfulness is from generation to generation. We recognize your goodness, we recognize your mercy, we recognize your deeds in our lives, Almighty God. Father, we cannot just stop and say we have brought ourselves this far. We cannot attribute it to our minds, we cannot attribute it to our networks, we cannot attribute it to who was with us or who was against us. Lord, we can only attribute it to you, O God. Father, we recognize you. We recognize you. We join David. Lord, Lord, we join David and we say, I will bless the Lord at all times. At all times, I will bless the Lord. At all times, I will bless the Lord. At all times, all times, I will bless him. I will bless him. I will bless him, oh God. As I just get ready to just hand over this mic, I just want us to worship God with one song. Just one song. Just to tell him thank you. Just to tell him thank you. Just so God can never get tired of hearing you say thank you. He can never get tired. He can never get tired. We just want to tell him thank you. And just want to sing a simple song that says, Vizazi, hadi vizazi vya kufahamu. Wewe uliye Mungu wa kale na Mungu wa leo. Vizazi, hadi vizazi. Vya kufahamu wewe, uliye Mungu wa kale, na uliye Mungu wa leo, sifa zako. You're glad you came to God's house. David said, I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. And you know what makes the difference? It's not the balloons, it's the presence of God. Hallelujah.